Yo, what's up, y'all? This your boy Raw coming at you Raw. I hope your day is all well and God bless you for stopping by. Now, I recently did two videos, and you can check them out on the channel. And the video format there was just streaming. The other one was me using my phone. And just to get content out, I may have to do those things. You know what I mean? Because doing all this sometimes burn you out. Like all this editing and all this triple decking and, you know, trying to top your last video off is kind of tiring. So you might catch me using, you know, streams to do videos or even my phone. But at the end of the day, the most important thing is that I communicate with you guys via these videos, and I'm happy when my dudes can join me, and that's who I'm with, my boy Maslin. Maslin, say hey to the people.
What's good, people? This your boy Maslin. You know how we get down. It's out in game, like we always do.
That's right. And this isn't gaming talk, but this might as well be called gaming talk, because we have some gaming news, some gaming discussion, because this is part two of my, I want to say, this is part two of my, is Nintendo Switch a gimmick? I put a question mark on there. The definition of a gimmick is something that attracts publicity, attracts attention, and anything could be a gimmick, you know what I mean? Sometimes, like if we go back to the Wii, the first Wii, right? The motion controls, which stuck with us. I would say motion controls stuck with us, so it might have started as a gimmick, but it became foundation. Like, you know, motion controls in VR, motion controls and just straight up controllers with the PlayStation R and the Nintendo consoles. Mass, does Xbox have motion controls in their console?
Kinect does.
The Kinect does. So motion controls with the Kinect. I think motion controls has stuck with us. Mass, my question to you is, Nintendo Switch a gimmick? Will the stuff Nintendo Switch is pushing forward, like, will we see evolutions of this? Like a console/handheld hybrid? Is that the future of Nintendo consoles, or is that the future of consoles in general? Or will it die? After the Switch.
So. I think Nintendo is in their own, you know, niche space. Mm. I think all the motion control stuff is a little gimmicky.
You think so?
When I was watching the streams, like it's when they were showing 1-2 Switch and ARMS, I wasn't personally like, yeah, I need this.
Oh.
But when I showed it to my kids the next day, they were excited about it.
They were excited? Oh, snap, so I can see that.
That those games are more focused towards that audience. And as we move forward with VR and AR, I think the motion control thing fits into that space.
Okay.
Because when you're in real life, quote unquote, in real life, when I'm sitting down playing a video game, I'd rather be sitting down with the controller or keyboard and mouse in my hand playing the video game.
Okay.
Or playing the game.
Yeah.
If I'm in VR or an AR type game, I would rather, you know, be moving in order to immerse myself in whatever's happening. So I think the problem Nintendo has is that they're trying to use AR via motion control, and to most people it just looks a little off. And if, for instance, like say you had a VR headset on and you were playing that little quick draw game that they had on 1-2 Switch and you're looking at your opponent, sure, but in the VR space, you're in the middle of a desert or in the middle of some Western type town.
Yeah.
That would be a completely different game than what you're looking at as a person just staring at someone, you know, playing that game.
Let me say this first. I said fresh. My bad, Maslin. But Maslin, let me say this. Like, the whole 1-2 Switch. When you look at the video of them playing 1-2 Switch, like, it looks silly. You know, it looked like they're imaginating. You know, they're being, you know how when you were kids, you imagine you were on a horse or you imagine you had a gun? You like, it really feels like that. Because if you're looking at each other, you're relying on the feedback of the game, you know, to really tell you what you're doing. So it looks silly from the outside looking in, but I can see that as a cool party game. No doubt I can see that as a cool party game.
Yeah, but here's the problem.
Mm.
How many parties have you been to where somebody broke out they Wii or, like, ever?
You're right. Look, let me hit you.
How many parties have you been to where the cool party game that they're trying to push it out to be, how many parties have you been to where that happened?
I know.
Anybody broke out, yeah, let me go get my Switch, or, like, where do you think that's going to happen?
I think that's only going to happen.
I've been to a lot of games, a lot of parties, with a lot of people who play games all the time.
Yeah.
At best, somebody, you know, as party wind down, somebody playing a game of 2K or Madden or something, or somebody decides, you know, get in around the Halo. Like, that is like the worst, or the best, I guess, case where somebody was playing a game at a party. But you having a party, and instead of enjoying the party or the people around you, all of a sudden it's, hey, let me pop out these motion control games and we can look
at in front of you. All right, let me hit you with this. Let me hit you with this, Mask. Like, you're right about that. You know what I mean? I'm just stating the facts that would be a cool thing in a party. Will it be used in a party? It's probably slim to none. Will it be used in a party? But the Nintendo Switch, is it a gimmick? Like you said,
I don't think it is either.
I think it
can be gimmicky.
It could be gimmicky.
Overall, it's a gimmick.
Okay, would you say Pokemon Go was a gimmick?
Would I say yes? Pokemon Go is a gimmick.
Pokemon Go is a gimmick. Do you think Pokemon Go, like, how would it kept from being a gimmick? You know what I mean? Like, is those type of things doomed to be hot on fire in the beginning and then die off later? Like, are those things doomed to be
like
that
I said,
way?
It's all about evolution.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and just like I was explaining earlier, if you take that same 1-2 Switch narrative, that whole, just the Western part, like, not even, because I watched the Treehouse Live, and there was a whole bunch of games on there that I was like, I don't know who want to play these, but they're on there. Like, it's the new, like, Mario Party Wii Sports combo type thing.
Yes.
But if you take those same type of games, and let's say you put it with a virtual reality headset, and you're using the little Wii motion controller as your quick draw gun. You have a headset on now. Instead of looking at another person, you have a headset on now, and you see like a Western theme in the headset. And you can look around left to right, and there's horses and tumbleweeds and all that. You have all that, you know, the Western sounds in your ears, you know, in your headphones or whatever. And then you do the quick draw thing. That's a completely different experience than standing in front of someone with the Joy-Con in your hand,
yeah,
looking him in the eye and then flipping it up. Like, the change from what seems extra gimmicky to what can be mind-blowing isn't far. It's just that from the outside looking in, it doesn't look like nothing has changed other than you're just standing there with the little controller in your hand. But to the person who would now have that VR headset on, and seeing all that, you know, I'm in the Wild West and I'm using this thing as my quick draw, that's a completely different experience.
Do you think Nintendo will eventually get into VR?
I think they'll get into VR once there's lower cost options. So when Microsoft starts putting out all those lower tiered VR headsets that they're supposed to come out with Scorpio, where they're supposed to be very affordable, a couple hundred dollars. When they start putting out those that have lower system requirements, and the other companies start getting in on those lower tiered options,
yeah,
I think Nintendo will also enter the market with, even if it's with they work with a third party that already has one that will work on the Switch or with the Switch in some way, shape, or form. But
okay,
it'll have to be one of the wireless ones.
All right.
So that, I think that is where the problem will come, because with the Switch itself having such limited capabilities when it's outside of the cradle, and it needing a wireless feed, I think that'll be the change point.
I feel you on that. I feel you on that. I think Nintendo, like, okay, $299. All right, look, let me say this about the price. You know what I mean? Remember how you were saying this is the and console, Nintendo want to be the and console? Like you said earlier, they living in their own bubble. And I think what you said earlier stands more true here than anything. I think Nintendo doesn't care about if PlayStation guys or Xbox guys come over to their platform, because everyone already knows why PlayStation guys are on PlayStation. Everybody already knows why Xbox guys are on Xbox. And everybody knows why PC guys are on PC. On Nintendo, I think Nintendo just like, hey, you like our products, fans? Here's the Switch. Jump over to this. Because I was listening to a video podcast from Digital Foundry. And shout out to those dudes. They do good data analysis for all the platforms and games. But they were saying stuff like, this is their successor to the 3DS and also the Wii U. I think if in the Wii U was in a way a step forward to the Switch, because the Switch in a way is a Wii U that you can take on the go now. Like they were comparing it to the Wii U, and I would say this won't be a gimmick, to go back to the title, if Nintendo keeps, like you saying, building on it, the evolution of the Switch. If the evolution of the Switch is a whole different type of console and a whole different type of unit, then we can look back and say, yeah, the Switch was just this thing. But I hope that at the end of the day, my biggest thing was third-party support.
Which they have.
They do have. But where's Watch Dogs 2? Where's Mafia 3? You know what I mean? Like these games that... See, that's what I mean. I don't think they care about the PlayStation in the Xbox and the PC guys. I really think they like... Go ahead.
To your point.
Mm-hmm.
I think, like, they have third-party support. And I think moving forward, we'll see a lot more third parties on Switch platforms. I believe that the way the Switch works, since it's cartridge-based, will require, you know, other companies to do a little tweaking, just because it's more like a digital media, but and tweak it for the Switch's controls, as opposed to doing complete carryovers to a different product. And I think that's where the third party support going forward will be fine. I think the reason that the older third party games aren't coming to the Switch is because they were already put on a certain developmental path of Xbox and PS4, and they came out, and then the ones that were moving forward, or the ones that are moving onto the Switch, also like Shovel Knight, I think, and Skyrim, those were already in a developmental state where they could be put on both platforms. Mm. That's why I think moving forward, you'll see more third-party games on the Switch, but the older ones won't, due to whatever conversion is necessary to move to that type of format.
I bet you these developers,
they'll start making games for the Switch, but they won't go backwards.
Mm. See, I bet
you, just like a lot of the older games didn't make a PS4 Pro mode. I think it's that same type of scenario. Going forward, you'll see more games with a PS4 Pro mode, and you'll see more games on the Switch, as opposed to taking the older game and bringing them up to this different standard.
Man, my hope is that... See, my hope was that Nintendo would be the console, a console that tries to compete with the other two. And you said it, that they won't, and obviously they aren't. Like, they're not competing against Microsoft and Sony. And as far as being an and console, I just think Nintendo doing what they're doing. You know what I mean? They're doing whatever they want to do, and this is what they want to do. And my whole thing is, you know, mad respect for Nintendo being themselves. But but for me, the Nintendo Switch has only one AAA game. Most of the, I'm talking about that releases with it, most of its games are coming out later this year. And like, when you hear stuff like Street Fighter, an old Street Fighter game being $40 stripped from the Xbox Live market, you know, that game, that Street Fighter game being $20.
Like Street Fighter 2.
Dude, that $40 for that game for the Switch. Like, my whole thing is, right now the Switch ain't looking like a day one buy to me. Now I could buy it even if I wanted to. It sold out everywhere. That's the Nintendo way, you know. Let's create that demand and let's sell as much as we need to versus let's put out so much. Now you got those guys on eBay selling them back for like thousands of dollars, you know. And my whole thing is, as far as day one goes, like, I can see Nintendo doing really well in the holiday season when Super Mario Odyssey comes out with Zelda right there ready for it, and ARMS looks very cool. Like, my whole thing is right now, you know what I mean? Like, it's going to be on fire like I predicted. I predicted the Nintendo Switch is going to sell big, and I believe it's going to sell big. It's going to be sold out for the next few months. If you can't get one now, it's going to probably be a while until you could get one.
I would like to point out that when we were doing our predictions,
mm-hmm.
I said,
oh,
and I quote, at the beginning, it will sell like hotcakes.
You did.
It'll be a low period, and then it will sell again during the holidays. Now, I just want to point out, I'm not saying I'm right, but I'm right. Like, at the beginning, Zelda is going to sell the heck out of Switches. Sell out. First few months, like you said, sell out. In those August to September months, well, August to October months, those 3 months is going to be a little low. Then Mario is going to drop. Sell like hotcakes again until through to the new year.
Man, my whole thing is, I like that Zelda when it dropped. Like, I do want to play that Zelda, but my whole thing is, like, after you beat Zelda, then what? You go back to your PC, you go back to your Xbox, you go back to your PS4. Like, my whole thing is, it's gonna be able to access the Wii U library via, like, online capabilities?
I don't know. They didn't specifically specify that. But this is the first Nintendo console in a while that hasn't had backward compatibility. So I don't know exactly how that's going to work out, considering the onboard storage is 32 gigs, I think.
Yeah.
You can add SD cards, but that's going to be like a big chunk of memory if you're trying to play something like Xenoblade Chronicles X or something until, you know, in the wait for Xenoblade 2, or you're, you know, trying to play one of the Super Mario vs. Luigi or something like that. When you're trying to play those games, that's going to be a big chunk of space to take up on the memory of the Switch.
And I want to ask you,
I don't know how the access goes. They did say that with their new pay-to-play online thing, which...
Oh,
you didn't know?
No, I did. I took notes.
Oh,
look.
Oh, yeah.
That's a little bit...
But with that pay-to-play online, they said they're going to give out NES and SNES games monthly. And those will be digital, but I don't think that there's any backward compatibility type situation in effect. Like, if you bought something digital, that you'll have it on the Wii U, that you'll have it on the Switch. I don't think there's any of that in effect. Unless I missed something. Possible, but I don't believe that is the case.
Right. Man,
I'm with you on the once you play Zelda, what is there? But it's the same thing for any console launch.
See, like, this is where I probably would say, go the other way on that, with that statement. See, Xbox, when it came out, it had Dead Rising 4. It had, Dead Rising 3, Rise, Son of Rome, and Forza. Now, game preferences are opinionated. You know what I mean? Like, if you don't like these games, you don't like these games or whatever. That's all opinionated. But at the end of the day, you can't take away the fact that when the console dropped, I'm talking about Xbox One right now, after you had your fill with Forza, you can jump over to Dead Rising, and if you had your fill with Dead Rising, you could jump over to Rise Center Rome, and if you had your fill with that, you can go to a third-party game like a Call of Duty, like a sports title or whatever. With the Switch, it's going to come out with Zelda as its big thing and Skyrim, and I don't even think Skyrim's launching with it. Is that a game that's coming later?
I don't know. They didn't give a date, mm-hmm. but...
It has to have that backlog. I told Fresh yesterday, if it can let me play 3DS games.
Well, it'll have, I think at launch, it'll have Zelda, Splatoon 2, I think, is a launch game.
You think so?
And I think so. And I think the Mario Kart Deluxe, I think that's launch. So that's their three big games. No.
Splatoon, let me tell you right now. I wrote this all down. ARMS coming out in spring 2017, so maybe March, maybe within March, if not before April or in April. Splatoon 2 is summer. That's summer 2017. Super Mario Odyssey is 2017.
It's fall, yeah.
Holiday. Then we got Fire Emblem Warriors announced, then Xenoblade 2 announced. 80 games in development, third party. And then we got Dragon Quest 1, 2, 10, and 11 on... the Switch, don't know when that's coming out. Square Enix Project Octopi Traveler or something. And we got Skyrim coming to Nintendo Switch, will be portable, but they didn't give a date. I remember that dude didn't give a date. And then we have EA on stage talking about FIFA later this year, coming out later this year. So even a sports game like FIFA ain't even coming out at launch.
Well, I think that's because everybody just assumed it was FIFA 17, but I think it's gonna be FIFA 18. And just, because 18 is going to come out, NBA 2K18, apparently, because that was in a sizzle reel.
Let me hit you with Mario Kart 8. Mario Kart 8 comes out April 28th. So, they're going to have games within the next 2 months, but my whole thing is, at launch, what else is there after Zelda? Like, you buy this thing for $2.99, you buy the game for how much? How you think, the games are $60, or will it be $50?
They'll be $60, but the same argument could be made. Like, when you bought the PS4 at launch, okay, right? You bought it for $400. What games did you buy with it?
Well,
Killzone.
Killzone. You had Killzone. You had Knack, and you had, what was the third game? Did it have a third game?
Right. So you bought $400 console.
Mm-hmm.
You bought a $60 game in Killzone, and then Killzone is what arguably 13 hours of gameplay?
Well, if you take in consideration with the custom games, because, you know, with me, I jumped into the custom games and literally made that game stretch, because I made this game called Alien Isolation Masculine. If you still got Killzone, we can hop on that. I made this game called Alien Isolation. Anyway, that's neither here or there. But like I said earlier...
I'm saying to my point.
To your point.
You pay $400 for the console.
Uh-huh.
You pay another $60 for... Killzone.
Yeah.
If you didn't play the multiplayer in Killzone, then it's a 13-hour game.
Okay.
I'm saying you play just through the story.
Okay.
Maybe 13 hours. I think that's on the high side.
Okay.
But if you play through Killzone, mm-hmm. if you bought Knack for some reason, then...
Boy, but Knack was good. You better sit down.
6 hours?
No!
6 hours, 7 hours?
But that's all preference. That's all opinionated.
Saying, if you bought Knack, that's about 7 hours. I'm giving them the benefit of the doubt that they bought all the games at launch.
What? Another was that game. Only so it, though? Far, was PlayStation?
It's $520.
Hold on, wait for it.
520 hours.
Okay.
$20, and you got about 20 hours worth of game.
No, that's not true.
By the Switch.
That's not, no. Let's go back to PS4, because you forgot the three other games that you could play for free without even buying. Plus, DC Universe Online. You had Warframe and Blacklight. Like I said, these games are all opinionated if you liked it or not, but still, you had other things to play.
You don't know what else is going to come out for the Switch. You don't know if they're going to have any free-to-play games. You don't know if they're going to have any absorbent demos. We don't know that. I'm just going by the retail buy. We're going by the retail. You buy this, you got these two games, and you bought these two games. You spent $520. Mm-hmm. For these two games, about 20 hours of gameplay.
Mm-hmm.
You bought the Xbox One at launch, it was $500. You bought the three games you just said, now you spent almost $700.
Yep.
You buy the Switch at launch, it's $300. You buy Zelda at $60, you spent $360. The Zelda's gonna easily have 60 plus hours of gameplay.
But look, my whole thing is
saying it like, what else is there? In the same time span or with less money, at launch, you bought an experience you wanted, and if you're buying a Switch, 1,000% you are buying it for Zelda.
Especially definitely. So Zelda had to come out with the Switch. It had to.
The people who are buying the Switch at launch know exactly what they're getting. They're buying the Switch, and they're buying it for Zelda.
Yes.
They're buying it because Zelda is a system seller.
Like I said earlier.
Going to sell the Switch.
Like I said earlier, like Nintendo, I don't think they care if a PlayStation guy or an Xbox guy likes their presentation, likes their console. I think they're aiming their cannons towards their fans, their fan base.
Yeah, like Zelda.
Yeah, people who like them. Like, hey, you rocking with Wii U? This is a big upgrade from Wii U. You rocking with 3DS? This is our new handheld answer. And my hope is, Maslin, my hope is, like, they let us download digitally 3DS games. Like, our Wii U games. My hope is that. Because if they say you could do that, then I would agree with you.
I want to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
Did you see the cartridges? Because are they the same size as the 3DS cartridges?
No, I'm talking about digitally.
I know. I'm saying if they're the same size as 3DS cartridges, then it's a possibility that you could be able to use
your 3DS
games on Switch.
They said. I think they said it already that you won't be able to use it. They said both 3DS and Wii U games can't be played, like talking about it how we are, like physical media. Right,
Wii U, that makes sense, but the 3DS, like, because in my head, it's as simple as, even if it's not the same exact cartridge, if Nintendo is smart, they can make an adapter, and you'll be able to play 3DS games on your Switch.
See, that's what I mean. Like, if the Switch was able, if they announced today or tomorrow before it releases, you were able to play all the Wii U games, all the Nintendo 3DS games. We got Zelda for you. We got 1-2 Switch, and we got down the line awesome games that's coming to the platform. If they say that, then I'll say, yeah, that's a day one buy. You guys gonna be happy. But at the time of speaking, they said they're not supporting no physical backwards compatibility with 3DS or Wii U. They didn't say they're not with digital, though. They need to explain that. They need to say that.
We don't know. Like, that's why I was going with that's why I only use the retail number.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, you're like the free-to-play games. I only use the retail games because we don't know what you're going to be able to do digitally at launch with the Switch, because they haven't announced their plans. And I think until we know what their plans are, we can't say one way or the other definitively what's exactly going to happen.
All right. I'll say this right now. If Nintendo Switch, look, I'm gonna let Maslin get it first then, because it's not a day one for me. I'm gonna let Maslin go, and he gonna come back on the channel and tell us what the heck the Switch is, God, or what it's doing for people other than Zelda, because that's what I'm looking at. I'm trying to find out.
Get it regardless. Like I said, I already told you before the pre-orders went live that I pre-ordered it.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'll have mine day one
for sure, and you could tell us. You can tell us if it's worth it. Tell us if that's your new Star Citizen spot, you know.
Oh! I give y'all my honest review.
Yo! There you go. Now, look. This video stretched to 30 minutes, but everybody who stayed with us on this talk, write in the comment section, how do you feel about the Nintendo Switch? Is it a gimmick, like the title suggests? With a question mark, like, we already put our opinions out, and we would love to hear your thoughts. Write in the comment section. Subscribe to my dude Maslin. His name is Dub Maslin now, right?
It's the real Maslin. DareMastilin.
Yep. And all you people who probably subscribe to the wrong Maslin, unsubscribe and subscribe to the right Maslin. This is your boy. I'm gonna have the link in the description. And yeah, you know what I mean? Thank you for sitting with us on this You know what, man? I'm gonna probably just call it Gaming Talk. Whatever. Oh, I might. I don't know yet. But anyway, that's all she wrote. This has been Raw, coming at you raw. Pieces.
Pieces.
We did it. But yeah, you know, I mean, this is about CFDs. The trailer just released about it, like some developer diary. And let me say this about that game. It looks really early in it looks very early in development. Like that game looks like that game coming out next year.